Good morning, friends. I'm Dr. Pinky Devi Aipan. I'm a board certified plastic surgeon and cosmetic surgeon practicing at Bangalore. So today I would like to discuss about a topic which is very commonly surgery which is commonly done by me, that is breast augmentation with silicone implants. So I just would like to discuss about what is silicone implants and you know how do I decide what size would be a good fit for a particular patient. So silicone implants, as the word says, are made up of silicone, and in most, so this is a silicone breast implant, and in most of the cases the filling inside it is also made up of silicone gel, and in few cases we also have saline fill silicone implants, but in most of my surgeries I'm using silicone fill silicone implants. So depending on the shape of the implant, it could be a round implant like in this case, or it could be a teardrop or an anatomical shape implant. And depending on the surface, it could be smooth implant or a nano texture or a texture implant. So in most of my practice, I've been using smooth implant or a nano texture implant and a round implant. So this is just to say what are the variable types of implant is available. And depending on the gel, the silicone gel fill in it, it could be highly cohesive. And in, there are a lot of inquiries about something called gummy bear implants. You know, a lot of women are asking, doctor, do you do gummy bear implants and what are gummy bear implants? So gummy bear implants are nothing but an anatomical implant with a highly cohesive gel inside so that they retain the shape much better than the other implants. So once we have understood this, so the what are the different shape and you know what are the different texture. So now how do we decide what particular size would be suitable for one particular patient? So it's not like, you know, every woman whom I'm doing a surgery with the breast implants, I would use the same size, definitely no. So how do I decide? So once the patient has come to me for an examination or for a discussion, I would go ahead with a few measurements and also about the clinical assessment and come to a particular size would be suitable for that patient. So what are the measurements I take into consideration? So the base width of the breast, the upper pole thickness of the breast and also the middle pole thickness and also the elasticity and laxity of the breast tissue. So these are some of the factors which I would consider while I'm deciding about the size. So once we know a particular size is good for a patient, so around that volume, I would discuss with the patient and you know help her decide whether she's comfortable with it or not. So once, so this is the base width, okay. So once we have decided the particular volume, then comes the question of how much of projection the patient wants. So projection is what the breast implant would project from the chest wall, okay. So it could be low projection, medium projection and a high projection. So this completely, the projection completely depends on a particular patient, whether she would, you know, like a high profile or a medium or a low profile. So once we have decided all this, the volume, the projection, and we are comfortable that it would be suitable for this particular patient, then comes the question of which plane or which pocket I would like to place this implant. So most of my cases, I'm keeping the implant in a subfacial, but we also have a subglandular and a subpectoral planes. So like in subglandular, we are keeping the implant just behind the breast tissue. In subfacial, we're keeping behind the pectoralis fascia, and in subpectoral, we're keeping behind the muscle, that is the pec major. So how do we, I decide, how does one decide which pocket would be ideal for a particular patient? So this would depend on the thickness, upper pole and the medial pole thickness of the existing breast. So in a woman, if she is very thin and if she has a very thin, low volume of existing breast, I would prefer to place it behind the muscle. This is basically to avoid any palpability of the implant. So this will decide what plane we are keeping. And once we have decided, then we need to decide through what incision I would like to place the implant. So either it could be perioral or in the mammary crease or the axillary. So most of the cases I do a inframammary crease incision, which is about 4 to 4.5 centimeters. So this is just to give you a rough idea of what are silicone implants. Now silicone implants are manufactured by different companies which have been FDA approved. So depending on the patient comfort and the sizing, you know, we decide about the implant. If you have any further doubts regarding breast implants, you could always contact us at Pink Apple Aesthetics. Thank you so much.